part one of our intestinal and urogenital flagellate lecture. So in this lecture, we will focus on giardiasis. Giardiasis is caused by the parasite Giardia intestinalis, or also known as Giardia lamblia. What they do is that they colonize and they reproduce in the small intestines, causing giardiasis. Distribution, they're most common in Canada, but there have been cases reported in Africa, Asia, and Latin America, where clean water supply is more often than not low. Children, elderly people, and people with a history of illnesses are also prone to contracting giardiasis at places such as daycare centers, where the risk of transmission is high. Giardia intestinalis. This parasite exists in two forms, the cyst form and the trophozoid form. The cyst form is resilient and dormant. Here, this is the cyst form. The trophozoid form, on the other hand, is mobile and less resilient against environmental extremes. This here is the trophozoid form of Giardia intestinalis. The cyst form. Giardia cysts are oval to ellipsoidal in shape, and their level of maturity is actually dependent on the number of nuclei present within the cyst. Mature cysts have 4 nuclei, whereas immature cysts usually have 2 nuclei. The cyst form, as I have mentioned earlier, is dormant and immobile, but they are resilient and can withstand environmental extremes. For instance, they can live for months in cold water. The trophozoid form. Giardia trophozoids are pear-shaped. The positioning of their 2 nuclei, their positioning gives it a smiley face appearance. Flagella can be observed. The trophozoid form is, as we have mentioned earlier, mobile but less resilient. Life cycle. The cyst enters the body when one consumes food or water contaminated with Giardia cysts. So this is through the fecal oral route. Once in the small intestines, exudation occurs, during which 2 trophozoids are produced. So 2 trophozoids are produced here. And from 1 mature cyst, and as we all know, a mature cyst has 4 nuclei. The trophozoids then multiply by binary fission. Encystation occurs as the trophozoids progress towards the colon, and that is where, and after that, together with the feces, they are shed, and the cycle continues when one consumes a mature cyst. Clinical manifestations. Usually when one suffers from giardiasis, they would experience diarrhea, flatulence, which is excessive gas, violent vomiting, steatorrhea, which is pale, foul, smelly, greasy stools, diminished interest in food, lose interest, and weight loss. To prevent giardiasis, you can follow the following steps. Boil water to kill the microorganism Giardia intestinalis. Also, avoid sexual activities such as rimming, or abstain from it completely, because such activity will result in anal-oral contact. Also, wash your hands in the proper manner after using the toilet. Treatment for giardiasis. You can treat giardiasis using the following drug, metronidazole, but this drug must not be administered to pregnant patients, as it is mutagenic to bacteria. So an alternative treatment would be berberine sulfate. That's all for today. Thank you.